In this lesson, we will talk about functions in Scilab. Functions are an important part of any programming language, and there are many words or names used for essentially the same thing, which are functions, such as some programming language call them subroutines. They're also called procedures or macros or subprograms. So all these keywords, they are essentially for the same purpose. So what functions do? So functions are basically a piece of code which we don't want to write again and again in larger programs. So we write that piece of code once, and then we call it in our main programs whenever we need. And we send some variables to this code, and then we get back certain variables from that code. So this is what the function do. So this piece of code is called function. So essentially, the functions are just a piece of code where we send certain variables and we manipulate those variables, and then we get back whatever we want. Some of the examples could be like we send 2 points to a function, the coordinates of 2 points, and we get back the distance between these 2 points. So this could be a function that we send, okay, this is our point x1, y1, and there is another point x2, y2, and we send these 4 coordinates to this piece of code, and we get back the distance between these 2 points. Similarly, another example could be that there is a rectangle, and we have 2 sides for this. This is a side A, or this is side B, and we send these 2 side data, or these 2 variables, to this function, and we get back the area of the triangle, and as well as the perimeter of that. So you can get 1 value from a function. You can get more than 1 values from the function. So every language has certain built-in functions. So similarly, Scilab also has a lot of built-in functions like square root, sine, cos, and tan, the trigonometric functions. And what you give here is you give some variable, any value, for example, x, and you get the square root of that value back. Similarly, these are the trigonometric functions, very popular. You can get the maximum of any vector or any matrix. You can also get the absolute value, the positive value. If you give a negative value here, you can get back the positive value. Similarly, inverse function is very common. You can use this to find the inverse of a matrix or inverse of a single number. And there are many more functions. You cannot count. There are hundreds of functions in Scilab. Now we will make 2 functions in Scilab. So the first function will take the coordinates of 2 points, p1 and p2. So these 4 values, x1, y1, and x2, y2, we will send this value to the function, and the function will return us the distance between these 2 points. And the formula of the distance, as you already should know, that formula of the distance is x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square, and this under root. So this is the distance formula. So the function will calculate the distance and will return back the distance. The second function we will be making here, because this function will return us 2 values. So you will know how to get 1 value from a function or 2 values from the function. So in this case, we will send 2 sides of a rectangle to this function, and it will calculate the area by multiplying the 2 sides. So side 1 multiplied by side 2. And it will also calculate the perimeter, which is basically side 1 plus side 2. This is the formula for the perimeter of the rectangle multiplied by 2. So the function will calculate these 2 values and will return us these 2 values. So this is what we are going to code next. So now let us make these functions. So first of all, we have to make the function for distance between 2 points. So we start our editor, Scinodes, and we start with the keyword function. Function is the keyword, and as soon as you press this space, the editor will show you this pair of parentheses and a word and functions. And function is the last word of your function. If you are returning only one value, you can just write any name of the variable, for example a. If you are returning more than one values, then you have to put in square brackets like this, inside this. And it's a good practice to use these square brackets anyway, even if it's not required for one variable, but you still use it. Then you say equals, and then you put the name of the name of the function. For example, I want to write this function as capital distance, let's say. In this parenthesis, you have to put name of the variables, and the number of variables should be the same which you want to send to the function. So in this case, we will be sending four variables, x and y coordinates of 2 points. So x1, y1, x2, y2. So you should select these names in a way that if someone else is looking at your code, they can guess what these values might be. So it's a good practice. But you can put any name here. It doesn't matter. Now we have to calculate this variable a, or you can call it d, because d is more appropriate for distance. D equals, and know the formula, sqrt, and then you start the parentheses, and within this parentheses we have x1 minus x2 whole square means hat 2 plus y1 minus y2 hat 2. So this is the formula of the distance, and then a semicolon, and your function is ready. This is the function, very simple. Normally we use functions to save our time when there is quite a bunch of code, like 50-100 lines, which we don't want to write again and again. So we write functions for that. But essentially you can put as many lines between function and end function as you like. This is just to give you what is the syntax of a function in Scilab, because every language has a little bit different syntax. So here the key points are that here, first of all, you have to write how many variables you want to return in these square brackets, then equal sign. And then name of the function. Don't put equal after the name. Equal should be before the name of the function, because we will be calling the function in this way, distance, and then we will be sending these 4 points. And then whatever value is here, that you will be calculating here, so that this you want to return back. This d will be returned. If you calculate something else here, some other name, then it will not be returned. This is the syntax. So now we have to save this first, and then we have to execute this function. So we save it, save, and whatever is that folder, you have to take note of this folder, because when you execute, you have to give the full path of the file. So I gave it the name distance. You can put any name of the file, but I will just keep the same name. So distance, and then as you can see, the extension is .sce, but this is only recommended. This is not compulsory. You can also use .sc or .sci as well. And then you just save it and close this. In order to execute, you have to give the full path up to the function file name with the command exec, exec. And then you start apostrophe, and then c colon, this is my path, users, and then the name of the function file, and then apostrophe close, and then enter. So if you see function and your function command and then end function, it means there is no error or there is no warning. So sometime you get warning when this function is already present and you try to redefine this function, then you get a warning here. So in that case, you should have a look that whether you really want to redefine or there is some problem. So otherwise, if nothing, no error, then it means the function has been successfully compiled. Now you can use this function however you like. So the only thing here is that the variable you are getting back should be here in your matrix. For example, I can say, I can keep in a, b, any variable, let's say a equals, and I should be giving the function name and the same number of variables. So distance, and then, so in order to check, I should first give a simple point, first point, so 0, 0, I think is fine, point at the origin, and my second point is 10 unit on the x-axis and 0 unit on y. So clearly the distance should be 10. So see whether program gives us 10 or not. So as you can see that it gives a correct distance. Now you can check with another simple point, and that is could be, for example, from origin to 3 units on the x and 4 units on the y. Because we know that if we move 3 on x, 4 on y, then the distance should be 5. And now it is correct. So it means our function is working properly. Now we define the second function. So psi notes once again. And you can cancel this because it's just asking for the same function. And now the second function is that we are sending two sides of a rectangle and we are getting two values. So again, you start with the function and as soon as you press space, it gives you these two things. Now let's say the program name is AP. AP means area parameter. And the values we are getting are 2. So therefore we have to put two variables here. So let's say A and P. Here we will be giving side 1 and side 2. So two sides. And then we have to put an equal sign before the function name here. And then we can calculate A and P. So A will be equal to the area side 1 multiplied by side 2 semicolon, and the perimeter will be equal to 2 multiplied by side 1 plus side 2. So just have a look once again, put a semicolon here, and parentheses are correct, and this multiplication sign should be there. Everything looks fine, so I just save this. Save. So now I can put a different name, like instead of AP, I put area P, the name of the function file, area P. So save it, close it, and now just put the name of the function file, which is area P. We enter, and again all commands were executed successfully. So it means we can use the function. Now this function is returning two values, so we have to put two variables, something like give me area and give me perimeter. You can take any variable names, equals, then we call the function. And what was the function name? Function name is this, AP, not the file name, but the function name. So AP, and then we give two values, let's say 4 and 5, and enter. So now we got this error. So why we got this error? Because the P, the function cannot find any variable P. Now here is the error. As you can see here that we should return two variables A and P, but we are returning only the variable A. So therefore the function is compiled successfully, but when we try to get the value from the function is saying undefined variable P. Because function, when try to return the value P, function cannot find any variable P inside the code. So it means this variable should be P because there is no P inside the function. So therefore we got this error. So now you can save again. And now as you can see, because we have defined this function before, so it is showing us the warning. So this was the warning I was talking about, that if the function is already defined, it will only show you the warning that it's you are redefining the function AP. So is it okay? Is it what you want? So there is no problem. So there is no error, only the warning. So now we can execute it again with the same variables. Give me A, give me P, and if we enter, it gives us the P perimeter and the area. So this is how you use the function, and these are the warning and some common errors which you will get when you try to make functions. So the definition of every variable you are returning must be inside the code of the function. So that is it for the functions. Now you can define any function. The number of inputs and the number of outputs should be proper, and all variables which are outputting from the function must be defined inside the function.